Hi, I'm Moses, and this is my last lecture.
My mom and dad lived comfortable lives in Ethiopia. My dad was the dean at a prestigious engineering college in a city called Bahardar, ranked second in the nation at the time. My mom, on the other hand, was the daughter of one of the top government officials. After they got married, they decided to move to the United States of America, mainly to explore the other side of the world and provide a better living for their children to come.
I was born in 2001 in Silver Springs, Maryland, about 10 miles away from the nation's capital. My parents had just immigrated from Ethiopia, and it was a little hard for them to adjust to life in a foreign country. Different language, different climate, even different culture. Everything was different in the United States of America.
3 months after I was born, my parents decided to move to the City of Angels, bright lights, Showtime Lakers, and a diverse multitude of people. However, things didn't get much better there. Because they were new to the area, my dad was forced to take up a job at a warehouse factory, even though he had a master's degree in engineering.
In spite of the situation, my parents stayed humble and did what they needed to do to provide a better future for themselves, for me, and for my younger brother and sister. They accepted help from friends, family members, and the people around them. They put down their pride, and as a result, things began to drastically improve.
In 2012, my family and I moved to Anaheim. While the transition was very hard, things didn't really change much until I started my freshman year in high school. I had a hard time adjusting, and that was very evident in my grades. I was lost, confused, and disorganized. I failed my first couple tests, didn't turn in some homework, and my essays were a mess. Some of this was my fault and came as a result of my shortcomings. But part of the reason was having to adapt to this new setting.
Through this tough time, there was only one thing that kept me sane. Basketball. Whether it was on the weekends, after school, or even during lunch, I'd always feel the happiest when I was on the basketball court. Here, I felt powerful, unstoppable, and free. It was at the basketball court where I met my closest friends and ended so many careers. While basketball helped a lot and allowed for me to let go of my worries for a little while, I would always be brought back to reality of my problems. However, I was able to do what my dad did way back when I was little, remain humble and rely on the people around. I asked my teachers for help, found some great friends, and I learned to lean on my family. At times, it was embarrassing, and I hated having to admit my weakness. But in the end, it was thanks to the efforts of the people that were close to me that led to my eventual success.
A monumental event that happened in my life was the summer of 2016 trip to New York and back. As we drove across 30 states and 8,600 miles, I really appreciated the diversity of our nation. I've walked among the shadows, you wiped my tears away, and I've felt the pain of heartbreak, and I've seen the brighter days. And I break rest to heaven from my lowest place. And I have held the blessings God you give and take away. No matter what I have, your grace is enough. No matter where I am, I'm standing in your love. On the mountains I will bow my life to the one who set me there. In the valley
I am eternally grateful for my friends, family members, and everyone who's been with me since day one. Without them, I wouldn't have been able to reach the point in my life of where I am today. Not a day goes by where I don't remember my situation, where I was a year ago, and how I bounced back. and has taught me many valuable lessons that I'll remember for the rest of my life. Thank you for watching, and thanks to everyone who's made an impact on my life. And a diverse culture of people with them.
Parents decided to move to the City of Angels with its bright lights.